Brentwood High School. I'm Chloe Robertson.
And I'm Jackson Bell. Here's what's making news.
The Brentwood Bruins football team is off to a 1-1 start. This week they play at Stewart's Creek, and the Bruins' hope is to keep their championship hopes alive. Brennan Chapman has more.
Mike, let's do keys to the game real quick. Thank you, Cork. Can we do that?
The Brentwood Bruins are off to a 2-1 start. We asked Coach Evans what he thought about the team's performance so far this week.
So far, I think we've done okay. We've got a lot of places that we can improve. Week one against Franklin, it's always a close game in the history of 40 games against each other.
I asked Coach Evans how he's prepared the offensive line so far this week for the game.
So a continual improvement. So we've done some things in the last couple of weeks that we've improved on every week. I think our feet are getting better. I think our double team movements are getting better. And that's really the focus and the emphasis that I'm putting on them this week is making sure we're comfortable with our assignments for pass protection, given we have a sophomore quarterback who's starting. So giving him time to be comfortable, to get the ball to some of our playmakers and let those guys do their job. But we know that it's 1-for-5 and 5-for-1 for us. So we all have to be on the same page and do the same thing in order for the offense to have success. Because if we mess up, then the play can't work. So,
Brendan Chapman, WBHS 9 News.
Students across the country will be taking the College Readiness Comprehensive Exam, known as the ACT. It will be given on Saturday, September 8th at your local high school. Make sure you find out what room exactly you will be taking the test in. Students, make sure you get a good night's rest and a good breakfast. Coach Moore and the wellness teachers are getting students in shape. PE students have been taking part in circuit training here at Brentwood High. That's where you go from one station to the next for 20 seconds, performing exercises like sit-ups, jump rope, and seeing how high you can jump. In the coming weeks, students will take part in yoga, badminton, and ping pong.
Still to come.
News on the upcoming Tennessee State Fair for you and your whole family.
Prince's Hot Chicken. How hot do you want it?
The time of funnel cake, cotton candy, and no gravity rides is upon us. The Tennessee State Fair will take place from September 7th through September 16th. General admission tickets are $6 and an all-day ride pass is $25. Be sure to grab your friends and family for lots of fun.
The class of 2022 is showing its school spirit. The freshmen held a tailgate at the Franklin football game. Here's Wright Mantooth with more.
The seniors just came to us and told us it's time to get freshmen involved for the first time. So we're excited to be involved in the student section, and our grade's pretty excited too.
As you heard from Owen Bergen and Molly Rencher, the freshmen are very excited to be involved in school spirit pregame activities. The freshman tailgate was just one of many things that the freshmen have planned for this year.
Yes, we have staff to get freshmen more involved.
Right Mantooth, WBHS 9.
The annual Pilgrimage Festival will be held from September 22nd to September 23rd at the park at Harlandsdale Farm. There will be amazing food, music, and elements of the pilgrimage culture. The festival will be headlined by performances from Chris Stapleton and Lionel Richie. We hope to see you there.
People from everywhere are excited about attending the Breakaway Music Festival on October 5th and 6th. Wiz Khalifa, Lil Skies, and Lil Pump will be performing. Here's Ross Wilkerson with more.
One of this year's biggest concerts in Nashville, the Breakaway Music Festival, will be held at Bicentennial Capitol Mall State Park. This year's artists include Wiz Khalifa, Lil Skies, Lil Pump, and many more. We talked to Owen Kaufman, a music producer and student at Brentwood High School, for his expectations for the festival.
My expectations for the festival are to have a good time and make people remember the name, I guess, and expand my portfolio with concerts and just try and get bigger as the year progresses. I got new music, specifically electronic, through a buddy of mine who showed me a Chainsmokers set that I really enjoyed. Had a lot of deep electronic that I really liked. Always found a passion for it just from a young age, and something I really like.
Ross Wilkerson, WBHS 9.
For joining us. I'm Chloe Robertson.
And I'm Jackson Bell. See you next time on WBHS 9 News.